Adobe's just added some new features to Lightroom. Let's have a look at the top three. The first one is grain in masks. So if you look at this aerial shot I took, you can see that there's grain there in the sky and different parts of the image. Now, sometimes you might want to blur the background a little bit. So we're going to create a mask. And under the mask, we're going to choose the linear gradient. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to drag down in the background. And of course, this is just for demonstration purposes. I don't necessarily want to actually blur the background on this photograph, but I want to show you how it would work. So we do that. And if you wanted to blur it, we go down to Effect. So we take our texture, let's just take it all the way down and just a little bit of negative clarity. I'm not a huge fan of negative clarity, but we can put a little bit in to blur that background. Now, here's the problem. Look at the sky. See how now the grain doesn't match the rest of the image. In fact, if we look at it before and after, we can see there's no grain. So they added grain in here. So now we can add a little bit of grain back. And of course, this is only going to apply to where the mask is. So I'm going to use a tiny little bit of grain there. Take that size down really small. And let's reduce the roughness. And let's have a look on the eye. So that's pretty close to the original grain. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. The second new feature is really kind of hidden, but it's super useful. So if you want to make adjustments to the colors individually, we go under the HSL color. That's hue, saturation, and luminance. Hue is the color itself. Saturation, how much of it. Luminance, how light or dark it is. Now, instead of having to tab through these, we can just hit all, and this will just break them into sections. Now, the challenge is, say I want to change the saturation of the red. I grab the red and I start moving it, but I can't really clearly see where I'm making the difference or if I'm even trying to change the right range. Here's the new feature. If you hold down the Alt or the Option key, it will hide all the colors except for the color that you're moving. Right now we're doing saturation. We can see just the reds. So I can make those adjustments, release them. Now, the other thing is if you want to see what region a particular color is in, if I hold down the Alt or the Option, I can tap and say, okay, there's where all the oranges are. Here's where all the yellows are. And you know what? Those yellows on those trees, I'd like them more green. So let's go into Hue, tap, and now as we change these, notice you can push those into more of a green. Now, you probably want to mask them away a little bit in the sky. Now, the other one is there's an on-screen adjustment tool, a TATS, a targeted adjustment tool, and that's these little icons here. And if I click and start to adjust it, we can change those colors. So if I want to get the green out of the sky, just drag that down a little bit, and looking good. Same with the luminance. Let's make those blues a little brighter. If I release, you see the whole image. Hold down Alt or Option, you can see just the area that's being adjusted. The on-screen adjustments are not new, just the ability to hold down Alt or the Option key to see the colors that are being adjusted. And the next feature I want to show you has something to do with the curves. So let's make an adjustment here to this shot from Back Bay, and you're getting a little tour of some of my drone photos here. But we want to go into the tone curve. So say I wanted to, I don't know, brighten up the shadows a little bit. And I'm just going to make these adjustments. I actually was happy with the original, but I just want to show you how this works. So say you make some adjustments here. I'll maybe go this way, give it a little more contrast in the mids there. All right, great. Now, as you're making those tonal adjustments, it's also adjusting the saturation of the color. So the new one is to refine the saturation. So there's a slider here. I can drag this back. And what this will do, notice, is it will take you back to the original saturation of the image. So when you take that down, all you're adjusting now is the tonality of the image. And I just want to show you how well this works. Now, this is something I wouldn't do to the image, but I'm going to push it the opposite way to get some bronzing going on in here. Okay, so that's, we've clearly got some issues there. And if we pull this back, notice it restores the original colors. So I wouldn't adjust a photo like this, but I just want you to see how well this feature works, and you know, and something that's just very clear and easy to demonstrate. So I'm curious what you think of these new Lightroom features. Let me know in the comments underneath. And if you want to see more of the Lightroom new features, check out this playlist that I made right there. And if you're new, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications so you don't miss any more of my videos. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.